The American Revolution. One of the greatest wars in the history of America. Among all of the men that were associated with the war, one stood out and fought for the belief of freedom of the people and the truth of justice. That man was Thomas Paine. Tonight, you will hear from the man himself, Thomas Paine, and a group of his close friends and neighbors about the life of this great writer and philosopher. Paine was born in Thetford, Norfolk, to Joseph and Francis Paine. Joseph Paine was a master corset maker. When Thomas was 13, he came to work for his father at the corset shop as an apprentice.
How does this look?
Oh, God.
Oh, yes. He was a terrible corset maker. We all laughed when he opened up his own corset making business. It failed terribly. Right after he got married, if I'm not mistaken.
Indeed. Thomas Paine's corset making business failed soon after he was married. Her name was Mary Lambert.
Oh, what a sad tale his first marriage was. They planned to have a baby, but tragedy struck.
Mary Lambert went into early labor, and she and the baby died during childbirth.
Sorry, sir, but we've done all we can.
Why is my life so full of pain?
Before this day, Thomas's name was Merriweather, but he figured that pain better situated the events of his life.
Unfortunately, that is not true. After his wife's death, Paine moved around a lot.
Oh yeah, Thomas Paine, he moved all over the place. All over Great Britain, you know, France, America, you know. It was really strenuous on my part. Are you gonna see him later? Okay, alright, give him this note. It says stay in one country. Signed PJ Mover.
In between movings, Paine met a man that would change his life forever. Benjamin Franklin.
When Benjamin met Thomas, he persuaded him to come to the colonies. One move that was full of common sense.
Benjamin thought Thomas was a great thinker. Well, of course he was. Whenever one of Benjamin's friends were discussing philosophical ideas, Thomas was able to explain it in a more logical manner.
Yo, man, we could be like freedom and justice and like, you know, like power to the people, man, and stuff. You get where I'm coming from, man? I can explain that logically!
Thomas's writings were really great. Yeah. They were really full of truth and really resembled the writings of Voltaire and John Locke.
Thomas wrote some of the most famous works. He wrote the screenplay for Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. He wrote The Communist Manifesto. He wrote The Da Vinci Code. And he was the creative consultant for Bananas in Pajamas.
This was also very untrue.
Thomas Paine's most famous pamphlet was, of course, Common Sense.
Hey, Tugger, did you read this Common Sense pamphlet yet?
But I can't read, sir.
Oh. Well, it's very good.
Thomas Paine's Common Sense is now believed to be one of the main causes for the American Revolution.
After the American Revolution, Thomas Paine was not done. Oh, no, no, no. He had to spread his knowledge to the people fighting the French Revolution.
One of Thomas's pamphlets, The Age of Reason, got him in trouble in France. He was imprisoned for a year.
He used his experiences of being in prison for a year when he helped write the last episode of Seinfeld. Yes, you know the one where they get put in jail for a year at the end. That was a funny episode.
Once again, untrue. However, for the first time tonight, we will hear from the man himself, Thomas Paine.
And I, Stephen Jutkowski, sat down with Thomas Paine to discuss his great life.
Thank you for sitting down today with me, sir.
Yeah.
So, what are you most proud of in your life?
Okay, when are we gonna be done here? I have some pamphlets to write.
Sir, if you just answer my question.
What am I gonna say that hasn't already been said in the other interviews? I'm getting out of here.
Okay.
Yeah, good book? Yeah, good book of lies. Yeah, deism. Age of reason. What? What's this? Stay in one country.